Welcome to another episode and video on my robotic arm with wrist and a pneumatic hand. Counterweights to compensate for the weight of the hand with the wrist. Here is the controller, the robot interface with extension to control via computer, programmed in Python, everything. The compressor engine, this is original Fisiotechnic, this is made by Fisiotechnic, but my design, since the original idea didn't work very well. Some valves for the pneumatic hand and a pivot motor with bipolar switch, so it doesn't need programming, just going in one program to go in one direction and the switch switches the direction. Then what is the focus about? Again, it is about the wrist, of more appropriately the yaw engine, and there are a few basic directions within robotics: roll, pitch and yaw. Roll is like this, and that is what this is for, but it is disconnected because it has some quirks that I haven't solved yet. Then there's pitch, which is this movement and up and down, and up and down over a horizontal axis, and that is done by this vertical gearbox with a cord. So this is the pitch. Then there's yaw. Yaw is this movement, and that is done by this engine, another motor, just like the other. Just like any other motor of this, and it has is connected to a winch. The roll is connected to another bipolar switch. Now the point is that, and if you have watched this video series, you know the story. This mechanism is touching this switch, this motor stops, that motor runs for 2 seconds, end of story, this motor takes over again and goes. So it is about timing. And last time I have been exercising or trying to get the software correct, and found out there was some timing problem. Not only with how much time does there actually pass, but also which part of the software is actually being executed. And that turned out to be a big problem, because a part of software that actually takes time or should take care of one movement or timing did not work. So now I'm going to proceed with that. Do I get it to work? I got one hint, so I'm going to see if that hint is actually true. So let's check out the software and see if I can get it to work. Right, so here we get the software, and this is how I express anything in milliseconds. The weird thing is that last time I found out that some things may happen in the same millisecond. I find that hard to believe, especially with a fairly old computer like this one. But you never know. And the hint I was talking about was indeed true, that this actually needs to be concluded by this, because the off, and then I go up, this defined function actually was not executed, it was not done. So now with this was the hint that it is actually being done. So let me save this and do and see whatever happens. I'm quite curious now. And once again, because the roll motor has been disabled, wire disconnected, I have to press that switch manually. So press, and I have to press it long time, and now I see it. Okay, the motor runs, the roll motor, the yaw motor, but I'm more interested in the fact if off is being executed, and yes, it is being executed. Now is the interesting part. How about timing? 43 milliseconds, 44. So this takes 1 millisecond. Then this is in the same millisecond. This is in the same millisecond, which I find very hard to believe. Then trivial time end is 57. So between this part, this point, and this point, there is suddenly 13 milliseconds difference. Really. Then it goes up to digital 10, whatever. Off start. Here. Well, now it indeed executes, so this hint was very legitimate. And then I get within of 4 seconds, 4 milliseconds timing. So this means that this gets 4 milliseconds. Now, the point is, it should take 2 seconds. So this is a duration that it takes, then a port, or then to this definition, which is here, and a port, which is here taken, and then this says, okay, off. And this whole thing should take 2 seconds. From here, no, that's not true. It goes on. Oh, wait, here goes something wrong. So, duration 2 goes on and then should be shut off. So, where does my reasoning go wrong? That's a good point. It goes on in one direction, okay, right. And left is also correct. But in between, it has to be switched off. Ouch. On the other hand, does it really go left? Let me check that. So, and by the way, this switch has to be pressed for
an abnormal long time before it's being hit. And that is another problem to solve, because the bipolar switch is just being switched over, and that time is way shorter than 4 seconds. Anyway, let's go. So I press 11 again. Okay, there it goes. And it keeps rolling to the right. And it doesn't stop. I press again. Yeah, all right. This is futile. So it doesn't stop at all. Even the stop doesn't work out, because it just keeps on rolling. So off doesn't work, and it has two times on, after another, while this should be off and this should be on. So not entirely as expected. Some resyncing. Okay, so some thinking. Trigger yaw. Here on 2 is being activated, going here. And here is what I just was thinking about. Direction and direction. Python is self-declarable, which effectively means that you use it with a digit, so it gets an integer. But this is not an integer, this is a string. So I better cut this down. And then I have to cut this down. And there is clearly some other thing in Python. So let me put this. And now it is another variable which can be used. Then you go right through it. Timer duration off. Off goes here. And the port is being switched off. So all in all, this should work. Then Y is on called for twice. So let's switch here. Trigger yaw 8. Motor 8, 2 seconds, speed 1, and at the same time trigger yaw 7. Oh wait, I'm calling it. Wait. So first for port 8, 2 seconds, direction. Then 7, 2 seconds, direction. Is that correct? One and zero. Yeah, stop and go. Or whatever. Right, no, right and left, of course. So one is right. Let me put that in. Motor 8. 2 seconds. Right. Yes. And then this is obviously motor 7, 2 seconds and left. So if I say here, I press it, port 8, direction, which is correct, comes back to trigger you. So it ends and it calls it immediately on the other port, and that's the problem. Because it calls off, and off is obviously not being called. It says start timer, but off is here not being called. So that is still, did I tested it? Wait, once again, invalid syntax. Oh, yeah, right. I'm using, that's a mistake, of course. Command in Python is this. So, now it is all right. Go. Pressing the switch again. And this goes wrong again. So it isn't solved. Trigger on, trigger you on, and here's off. So despite adding the two brackets here, which in itself is correct because now off is at least being called, but here it is not being called. It should be called every time, on and then off. And that is not happening, because if this is being called, no matter what, then I should be see this, and that's not happening. Okay, that's a problem. All right. I had to change here as well, because this is about direction direct. So in the on-screen stuff, that makes a difference, at least in here. The other thing is still that I am looking at the milliseconds. Microseconds is very short. This is 55, and here 56. So within that same microsecond, it is very strange that the 2 seconds is not being dealt with. Now, this timer operation starts the moment this is being called, or after this being called. So 2 seconds, and then this one is being called at. Now if you look here, 55, am I looking at, wait a second, I'm looking a little bit wrong, because this is all 77. And here something happens. This is 77 and this is 79. And if we're talking about milliseconds, then this is a second. This is the second. And here we are 2 seconds further. We skip 2 seconds, which is exactly what is supposed to happen. 2 seconds. But here I press the switch. Trigger U is being dealt with. On. No off. Again on. And then off. And between this one. This is trigger time end, by the way. So this is start, then on, and off should be called here. Straight away, but it's called here. So my algorithm could be wrong. But this is indeed 2 seconds. So where does my thinking go wrong? Interesting. Yeah, this is definitely being called 2 seconds after the duration. So that is exactly what should happen. Duration 2 on. But this, then this doesn't make sense either, because here it leaves the trigger yaw, which makes sense because this is time end, which is after timer. So here it should go to off. Before between these lines it should go off, to off, and between these two lines. And that doesn't happen. Wow. And it is being called, obviously, with 2 seconds. So why does it go wrong here? And there's something else I just found, apart from time duration not being called when it should be. Right here I have direction and after which is supposed to be printed direct. So you should have on to colon direction and then either right or left. But look here, it says 1. This is not an L, this is an 1. This is a 0. So that does not make sense. Doesn't make sense at all. Now I could change this perhaps by doing this. As in a new print statement, but that shouldn't be any difference. Let's test if it makes any difference. Go, press the switch. Yes, there we go. Okay, stop. Ha, yes, okay. Print, and it prints literally everything. But what is being printed are. What was being printed previously 1. So, and here L, which is exactly what I want to be printed. So I'm removing this again. Save. Go again. Press 11 switch. And then what is happening? The same, the old thing. Oh no, now it is correct. Now it prints direction L and direction R. So why didn't it do it before? That's another weird thing. And yet, once again, which I haven't obviously solved yet, trigger on, no off, trigger on, no off, trigger off. So here, it goes on and then off without on. So no matter how I look at it, I can't explain. I cannot yet explain why this is happening. Then looking once again at the timer, 3612. All 3612, not 2 seconds. And yes, here 5625. So only here the 2 seconds happen. Still the question, why? And yet, again, no solution.
And it's once again time to say goodbye. Not solved yet, obviously. Some strange things happen in the code. Around trigger on and off. Or more appropriately, on to procedure. Why are things there happening? And why, for example, did it do the direction in the wrong type? And suddenly, after brackets, it did in the wrong type. I removed the brackets and it keeps doing it in the right type. Anyway, I should test everything, but it doesn't work the way I like. So I leave it at that. No full testing, not possible because this motor is not being connected. And this is not working perfectly. I could test the hand, but then again, never mind for now. So, anyway, thank you for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. Give it thumbs up, leave a comment or suggestion. You can follow me on Instagram. Please like and leave a comment. You can also follow me on Twitter. Please retweet, like and leave a comment. You can show your appreciation and support by making a small donation. And you can also choose to become a patron and have your name mentioned. More information under this video. URL of my website, my Instagram and Twitter names, and how you can support. Thanks for watching. To be continued. Bye bye.